In this video, I'd like to talk about how we can crank up machining effectiveness on this twin flow impeller component. Five-axis machining, especially roughing on non-uniform geometries like an impeller, inherently induce non-ideal cutting conditions. If you're making one piece, it probably doesn't matter. But if we're making a lot of components all at once, what can we do to further improve this process and minimize ever so valuable machine time? I'd like to introduce our partners at Third Wave System and their unique production module software package. This is an innovative force-based analysis and optimization tool that can run right in Mastercam at the toolpath level. Let's jump into Mastercam and check it out. So let's look at this Blade Expert roughing operation. If I go into backplot here and backplot this, I'm going to expand out the backplot window so I can see the details here. And as I scroll through here, what I really want you to pay attention to is these feed rates, right? So watch those. You'll notice they go from 500 to 75 to 37.5. Now that's really the only feed rate variation I have. 75 is the cutting rate, 500 are the links and retracts, and then that 37.5 is a 50% feed rate reduction that I have on some of the first passes that enter into the cut. I arrived at these feed rates using the tool manufacturer feed rate recommendations and my own experience with parts like this in aluminum. I then ran some tests with the tools and adjusted by trial and error, avoiding overloading the tool and coming up with an acceptable cycle time. I still have the machine set up from an earlier video. Let's fire that up and check it out. This works, but when it really comes down to it, I have no idea what the forces the tool is experiencing throughout the cut. As a five-axis programmer, I'm used to the variation of sound and load across the cut and just trying to make the best of it. I could tune some of that out with crafty programming techniques like feed control zones or multi-passes that enter at different feed rates like I'm using here. This pass takes over 21 minutes and I'd really like to improve that. However, I'm at the mercy of what I perceive with my eyes, my ears, and possibly my touch by sensing vibration or chatter. But what if there's a better way? A way to accurately analyze and understand the forces at play? What parameters affect the cycle time? How far can we push the tool? Where are the places in the path we are leaving cycle time on the table? The ability to not only understand the process we are using here, but create and evaluate an accurate what-if analysis would be game-changing. This is where Third Wave System's production module really shines. Let's go back over to Mastercam and see the integration and the process and results from running an optimization. Once you install Third Wave production module and Third Wave Exchange, add the PM3D icon to the ribbon. Right-click and customize the ribbon. Add a new group under the Machine tab. Rename and add the launch PM3D command. Third Wave Exchange is a data transfer interface that streamlines production module project setups, so a user can easily and efficiently optimize toolpaths to achieve significant cycle time savings. Once this is done, navigate back to the Machine tab and launch Production Module 3D. Here you can export the toolpath in app format. This is all you need to begin the optimization process. You can also launch production module directly from inside Mastercam. Once launched, you can start building your project with the exported path, stock, and Mastercam tools. This is all you need to begin the optimization process. I'm not going to go into detail of the workflow of production module, but I would like to share some of the results I got working through this with the team at Third Wave. Third Wave allows me to go in and run a force analysis on this toolpath. So as you can see here, using the tool and the stock and the toolpath, I'm able to understand that I have peak cutting forces around 53 pound-feet of force. Now, I can also see I have these huge valleys where the tool is really not experiencing a lot of force here. And I'm left with a cycle time of around 21 and a half minutes. So if we start looking at an optimization here, I can take the approach where I'm almost gonna call this a tool saver, right? I'm just gonna level the load out. I'm gonna reduce some of the peak cutting forces, but I'm also gonna bring up some of those valleys. And to do that, I'm gonna use a feed rate that's about 1.33 times the baseline feed rate. This allows third wave to bring those feed rates up and equalize some of those forces. Now you can see that force being much more even throughout the cut here. This is gonna result in a cycle time of about 18 minutes or a reduction of close to 20%. My peak cutting force has now been reduced to under 27 pound feet, a reduction of 50% here. So let's talk about a second approach here. Maybe I wanna ratchet this up just a little bit more, right? So I allow us to take some more of those valleys out and bring that feed rate up to 2 times the baseline feed rates. This is gonna give me a reduction of about 26%. We're getting rid of even more of those valleys. We're allowing the tool to go faster, bring those forces up where we need to. You'll see that those peak cutting forces are also about 50% of the peaks with the baseline. For the last optimization, we're gonna take a little bit of a different approach and we're gonna really ratchet things up. We're gonna bring our max in-cut feed rate equal to 2 times the baseline feeds, right? We saw that the tool survived those max forces of the original baseline. Why not bring everything up there, right? So this is going to result in a cycle time reduction of 35%. It gets us down to about 15 minutes. And that peak cutting force is still under the peak cutting force we had at the baseline. It's a reduction of 2 times the baseline feed rate, but it's right about even with where that max was in the beginning. Now, once this optimization is complete and we want to utilize these changes, we need to import this information back into Mastercam. This allows us to interact and post out NC code to the Akuma just as I would normally. Again, launch production module 3D. This time choose import toolpath. Navigate to the app file that was output by production module and open. This will be the first optimization I showed. Once loaded, Mastercam reads in this new feed rate and the point data and locks the operation. Let's backplot it. Notice the new feed rates that are specified to comp for tool forces and load. Because this replaces the native Mastercam NCI, this operation backplots, simulates, and posts just like any other Mastercam toolpath. The need to switch machines or NC code formats does not mean I have to rerun the analysis. So I've got a camera set up in the machine. Let's get these 3 different optimizations that I showed posted out and loaded up on our Akuma 5-axis and see the difference. So as you can see, there is a big difference in cycle time here, bringing the cutting time from over 21 minutes per segment all the way down to 15 minutes for the most aggressive optimization. Now this is just one segment on one side of this small dual-sided impeller. On this one tool path, that translates to over 1 hour of time for the entire part. If I was making 8 of these things, that's an entire 8-hour shift saved on just one tool path. Imagine if this was a massive energy or aerospace component, the savings could be exponential. Sometimes, due to cost or material constraints, experimental testing is not a viable option. It needs to be right the first time. For this video, we really focused on cycle time, but it's not always just about that. Sometimes tool life or surface finish, or even finished part stresses are more important. To make informed decisions about which parameters to adjust, we must first understand the process. Machining is inherently a nonlinear process. Different materials respond differently to the inputs. For a full understanding, it is critical to have a truly physics-based material model that covers a wide range of cutting conditions. Material models like Third Wave uses enable you to test process conditions that truly help you innovate and get the most out of your CNC equipment. While Blade Expert offers programming simplicity unachievable by other means, sometimes the project calls for a little extra, and that's when it's worth a call to our partners at Third Wave Systems.